Good morning. Joining me today is General Manager of Physitrack North America, Mike Sloniewsky. Mike, how are you doing today?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Good, good. So I wanted to ask you a couple questions. First, how did you get into medicine, healthcare, and technology?
So my career began many years ago in healthcare operations and management, and I've been involved with it ever since. Have worked with both big and small companies in the healthcare operations and management space. Came to Physitrack about 3.5 years ago in order to run the North American operations, which by the way, have grown very, very quickly and very nicely for us.
Great. So let me ask you a little about Physitrack. Can you give me a quick explanation of what Physitrack does?
Yeah, absolutely. So I'll kind of give you a little bit of a background story real quickly. So the two co-founders of Physitrack, Nate Skwartzow and Henrik Molin, one being a successful tech entrepreneur and another one very successful manager of large global hedge fund running European and global operations, and they were great friends. And one day they're sitting on the beach, and you know, both of them are sort of scratching their head as Henrik's brother-in-law had to have knee surgery, after which point he was handed a piece of paper by the physician and the physician's team to follow instructions post-surgery. And the two of them sort of scratched their head and say, "Listen, in this day and age of apps and mobile technology, it's amazing that a surgery that costs thousands upon thousands of dollars, the end result being a piece of paper that the patient's handed to walk through some exercises." So, you know, they kind of put minds together and came up with the concept, which then later became the business called Physitrack. And the kind of the core principle was that they were going to develop a web application and mobile apps for home exercise prescription. And so Physitrack has grown from that early concept and launch, which was begun in 2012, to today being a fully loaded patient engagement platform using technology like AI and data gathering, along with home exercise prescription, to help improve the patient engagement that a clinician might have surrounding a clinical care plan. And so if you think of things like that knee surgery from the founder's story, that knee surgery can, the experience for that procedure can be improved with the use of Physitrack apps and technology by providing patient education, home exercise, integrated telehealth, anything the clinician may need to stay in touch with that patient when they are not in the office or in the clinical care setting. And the end result is, you know, a better patient experience, along with clinical outcomes data and things that are contextual with what is going on with the patient's condition. So really, to sum it all up, it's really a way for a clinician or clinical team to engage a patient over a long period of time to help them drive a better clinical outcome.
Speaking from personal experience, I know how challenging doing rehab from an injury can be. It takes a lot of time and effort every day. And I don't think doctors really have time to be walking their patients through that all the time.
Absolutely. So, yeah. And when you deal with surgeries like the one you're describing, you know, only a small percentage of the time is spent by the patient in a clinical care setting. So whether they're with the doctor or whether they're with the physical therapy team, only a small portion is spent doing activity in the clinic. A lot more of the time is spent at home or at the home gym, if you will. So a lot of gains can be made if the patient stays on a regimented care plan.
So what you guys offer is kind of a hands-on service that's not actually hands-on. It's done through video.
It's done both through video and the use of, you know, PDFs and other tools that help keep that patient on the care plan. So it could be, you know, video exercises. It could be educational content. It could be, you know, streaming a telehealth session to help check in on a patient, you know, a few weeks after surgery. It can be any one of those things that are embedded in Physitrack. And of course, sort of bookended with our automated intake, or we call it AI product on the front end that can help triage patients into your healthcare system. And of course, on the back end, we've got a solution called PhysiData that helps larger healthcare organizations aggregate clinical outcomes data and patient data to help make better sense of it on a larger scale.
Okay. So that's a good explanation of what Physitrack does. Next, I'd like to ask how Physitrack fits into healthcare and technology. Kind of what's your place in the market, and maybe a little bit about how you would like your business to move the industry forward.
So, you know, we see Physitrack as, you know, a great set or platform of tools that help clinicians better treat their patients. So, you know, first and foremost, like DrChrono, we service clinicians first. Clinicians are sort of our primary users, and we help them better access and better engage and treat their patients for whatever purposes they may have. And as you know, has been well published, DrChrono and Physitrack both met through an introduction with Apple. So Apple, through their tech accelerator program known as Mobility Partner Program, were introduced to one another. And we really quickly sort of hit it off and developed a technical integration between our platforms to make the workflow for the clinician easier. And so what we see for the future of our platform is improving upon and adding to the tool sets and the capabilities within Physitrack to better help clinicians manage patients when they're not in the direct clinical care setting. We're going to continue to grow in that direction.
Would you say you guys are kind of optimizing that patient experience?
Yeah, so good question. So I think, again, kind of creating some definitions, I think DrChrono is expert in and has created a solution that's very good at facing the clinician. So any technology that's designed and needed by clinicians or clinical health systems to service and face clinicians, DrChrono has done that very well. We, on the other hand, have created tools that help the clinician face the patient. So one is clinician-facing and the other one is more patient-facing. So by marrying the two solutions, you have sort of a complete tool that helps better manage the patient journey from before they enter the clinic all the way through kind of their last step of completing a clinical care plan. And so everything that we do in that integration helps improve both the clinician experience and the patient experience, again, ultimately to drive a better clinical outcome.
Right. And outcome-based care is becoming more and more prominent because of MACRA. Where do you see maybe trends in healthcare and technology headed, and maybe a little bit more about how you fit into that?
So, you know, our great question. So our data gathering system, both within Physitrack and PhysiData, is actually MACRA or MIPS quality payment program compliant. So between the information that's gathered within EMR systems like DrChrono, and then the patient activity and outcomes data that's gathered within Physitrack, the combined solution really offers a great platform for doctors and other clinicians to relatively simply and easily gather and deliver the outcomes data that are needed as part of MIPS and MACRA to help meet those requirements. We see our role in that as figuring out ways to do that more effectively and more efficiently, because you know the optimum way is not to ask clinicians to do more work or to enter more data. So it is the goal of both, you know, Physitrack and DrChrono to help make that data gathering more streamlined, more efficient, more effective, in order to gather the data that's required as part of MIPS and MACRA. Again, because the ultimate goal of those programs is to have systems and plans that gather data in order to prove that the treatments that are rendered to patients are cost effective, are effective, but ultimately cost effective.
Okay. So at Physitrack, what kind of cutting edge technologies are you guys using to stay relevant and competitive in the healthcare and tech market?
So again, a good question. So, you know, we, again, back to kind of the mission of helping clinicians more effectively and more efficiently manage their patients over time. We're all about that. So any of the kind of cutting edge technology that are available, we're looking at, and things that are applied or are applicable, or things like, you know, machine learning, AI. These are all tools that are technological tools that ultimately help clinicians or help provide more data and more information to clinicians so that they can make better decisions. Again, the goal is ultimately the better outcome for the patient and the better experience for the patient. Any of these tools that help help that journey or help in that journey are things that we're looking at. So again, so things like machine learning, things like AI, potentially mobile first, things of that nature that provide data, improve experience, drive outcomes, we're looking at and exploring now.
Okay. So it sounds like you guys are a very data-driven company, and that fits right in with these kind of trends towards machine learning and AI. That's very exciting for you guys. Can you go a little, you mentioned the mobile first. Could you go into a little bit about how you guys are using mobile?
So mobile, I mean, if you think about it, thanks to Apple and other providers of mobile technology, but really it's about Apple for us, because we have learned a lot from Apple as it relates to user experience, as it relates to user interface. They've been instrumental in helping us, you know, sort of redesign and retool our user interface over time. Mm-hmm. That was the beginning of our partnership with them as part of Mobility Partner Program. And, you know, there are well over a billion of these devices, you know, if we're talking about phones in patients or customer pockets. Mm-hmm. We are continuously trying to figure out ways to have those devices be used as sort of a first line tool for consumers turned patients or consumers turned clients in their pockets. So, you know, the Physitrack AI or automated intake tool, for example, which just launched earlier this year, is something that we're developing in real case setting, right? So these are not things that we're developing and dreaming up and hoping that one day we find a commercial and clinical use for. These are tools that we have developed and are being used in clinical settings around the world. And so back to the automated intake or AI example, it's, you know, an app, a Physitrack app or a custom branded app on the front end that a client or patient might have that they interact with when they have the first incidence of a problem. And we use that that app, or we develop the app to help the healthcare delivery system triage the patient, if you will. So is your problem big or small? And what are sort of the parameters around your condition or your complaints? And based on how the consumer or the patient is answering those questions, the app helps steer the patient into the right next step within the healthcare delivery system. Again, we aren't developing those algorithms that the clinical healthcare organization is, but we enable that clinical workflow or those clinical algorithms for the healthcare institution. So in that way, you know, the mobile technology is sort of the first line of defense or first line of point of contact with the patient as they begin to enter a healthcare delivery system.
Interesting. Yeah. So that's a great point that, you know, these devices are in everybody's pockets. We'd like to say thanks Apple for everything you do for us. This kind of cutting edge technology is at everybody's fingertips, and you know, why not use these computers that kind of everyone has at all times? That's really cool.
Exactly. And one thing to add there, right? So the other thing is, and I said this at the very beginning, it's also very important for our company and Dr. Koujikov and other companies that are in the healthcare space to always remember that we help create tools and use technology to help improve clinicians' care of patients, right? So we're not in the business of creating technology or tools that replace that care. Mm-hmm. We're trying to put tools in the hands of skilled clinicians, doctors, therapists, other healthcare providers to give them more information and to help give their patients more valuable contextual information within what they're looking for to help, again, ultimately drive a better experience and better outcome at the back end.
Right. Yeah. I mean, I mentioned earlier that I've gone through, you know, rehabbing an injury myself. And I remember kind of being handed this piece of paper, black and white. It was a scanned copy of something what looked like from a textbook. And it sounds like Physitrack is kind of that next step of a more interactive solution that really, I mean, ideally is going to be, you know, used every day and hopefully maybe kind of fun for anyone who's trying to recover from any sort of surgery or injury.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. And, you know, one other thing to add there, right? So that's a very good point. You know, all the content, which is dynamic and growing within our library, is not just created by us, right? So we are not the clinical experts. We do have clinical, we have a team of clinicians that work with the company that help aggregate a lot of the feedback and information that come from, you know, tens of thousands of clinical users around the world. And they, you know, take that information from those clinical users and that feedback to help develop more content. So we're a very user-driven technology, and we develop both features and functionality within the system based on that user feedback. And so ultimately we're really good aggregators of all that feedback in order to create and improve upon a product that clinicians are already using. I mean, again, I mentioned we have tens of thousands of clinical users all around the world in 102 different countries, and well over, I think it's 2.1 or 2.2 million patients that have been on the system. So it's grown very, very quickly. But with that growth comes a lot of user input that comes back to the system that helps us more dynamically develop the content and the features and functionality within the system.
That's great. So that kind of addresses this theme of machine learning. You know, now that everything is connected and we can actually get feedback, like back in the day when I was doing my workouts to rehab my injuries, you know, maybe I had some feedback. I knew, oh, I like this, but I don't like that. This exercise makes, you know, this muscle hurt a little bit. All that information in the past kind of was lost at the wayside, but now you're saying you guys are able to aggregate that data and actually grow and improve the user experience. So that's great.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So next I'd like to get your opinion on maybe trends in healthcare. There's three major shifts that are driving big changes in healthcare. So there's the growth of digital technologies. As we know from Moore's Law, you know, technology is always getting better, faster, cheaper. So our hardware is always improving. The next major shifter is this kind of revitalization of social media. I've heard it called social media 2.0. You know, as a society, we've had social media for I'd say about a decade now, and it's here, and it's landed, and it's here to stay. The next step is learning how to use it to our advantage. And lastly, healthcare is becoming more and more catered to the consumer. people want to have high quality care for a low cost, so that maturing healthcare consumerism is the last major shift that's driving change. So my question for you is, who do you think benefits from these, and how do you at Physitrack fit in?
Right, so great topic, great question. I think, you know, all of these shifts, and they sort of operate hand in hand, all of them, in that, you know, there's more robust technology that's available in the hands of the average consumer than there was, you know, 10 years ago, let alone, or sorry, a year ago, let alone, you know, or 10 years ago.
Right.
And so that makes the continued development and deployment of our tool, the possibilities of the further development, even, you know, the more consumers have these pieces of technology in their hand, those are the more systems that we can operate with, the better off we are. And then you bring in things like healthcare consumerism and social media 2.0, which I think are slightly in healthcare the waste, in that patient experience matters for a few different reasons. You know, there are lots of studies out there that show that if patients have good experiences with whatever the episode of care that they're having, that ultimately they have a better outcome, whether real or perceived, the outcome is overall outcome is better. So if you can utilize technology and social media and the ability of those things to help tell stories and share positive feedback and share experiences, the better off the healthcare system is, right? So if you have a good result, if you have a good experience, and you can share that through social media and use that social media to connect that story and that story spread dynamically, you know, it's all positive, it's all uplifting. And so, you know, we're working with our customers and our partners like DrChrono to help navigate where we're going to fit in into that into those shifting areas. And so, sort of simply put, because we are technology based, because we are all about driving simple and easy use of technology to improve patient outcomes and patient experiences, we're sort of sitting in a very good position to be part of that story that'll be shared.
Great, great answer. And I'd like to ask you a little bit about moving forward. Maybe what technologies in healthcare in general are you looking forward to? It doesn't have to be Physitrack, but so what kind of growing tech are you most interested in?
So you know, I mentioned this a little bit ago, but you know, things like mobile first machine learning are interesting to us. We're also doing a lot of work with Apple and others, looking at things that capture human motion. So things like motion capture, things like accelerometry, those are technologies that we are looking at and continue to look at in trying to figure out how those things, how those technologies marry up with Physitrack. Again, all of which provides more data, more information that is contextual for clinicians to make better decisions to drive a good patient experience and good outcomes. So, you know, if I were to list them, I would really think they would be kind of the AI, machine learning, and really the motion capture and sort of the measurement of how bodies move, integrating all that within Physitrack. Those are the sorts of things that we're looking at.
Very cool. Great. So looking ahead, what's one thing you're excited about coming up in 2018?
So in 2018, you know, we continue to have dramatic growth with Physitrack. You know, from a business perspective, you know, our CEO had announced late last year that we're looking at a possible IPO this year. So, you know, time will tell. So we're excited about that. But from a technology perspective, you know, we see a greater acceptance of you know, mobility and mobile apps and technologies of that type that have been very popular and very front and center in sort of the consumer world for the last, you know, decade or two. I think they're really starting to come full circle in healthcare, where healthcare systems or healthcare delivery systems starting to see the value in technologies like Physitrack, like DrChrono, in helping improve that patient experience and helping improve that user experience. So we're really excited about sort of, you know, really getting these technologies into the mainstream this year and next year.
And congratulations on your growth and your success. So moving forward, what do you envision for Physitrack? Maybe your ideal future.
Yeah, so the ideal future, I think, is upward growth. You know, adding more users, adding larger healthcare systems that are utilizing our technology, and also kind of a wide expansion of what Physitrack can do, utilizing some of the technologies or advances we were talking about earlier in the system to help make the tool more robust and useful and help make that experience better.
Great. All right. Well, Michael, thank you for talking with me. Let's plug some stuff. Where can people find you?
Yeah, absolutely. So best place, best repository for info about Physitrack is at our website, which is physitrack.com. Honestly, it's a great, very feature-rich and information-rich website. We just relaunched it and updated everything within the last week or two. So you can find all the information on there. If you want to track us on social media, you can find all the links, of course, on that website. Or if you'd like to reach us directly, you can always catch us at support@physitrack.com. Or you can reach me directly at MS... and Michael S. is in Sloniewsky, ms@physitrack.com. Any and all feedback is great. We love hearing from folks and talking about what we do. We do it all the time and happy to do it.
Cool. Yeah. I got to say, when I was researching for this myself, I was on the Physitrack website and there's a great video there. It's short, maybe 3 minutes, that really explains what you guys do in a clear way. And I'd totally recommend people check that out. Great. Well, thanks for coming on the podcast, Mike. Hope to have you again someday, and hope to talk to you soon.
Okay. Thanks, Oleg. Have a great day.